Here I am at the city of Leiden. I came by train, and if you were expecting some beautiful vistas from the train and some commentary on the history of Den Haag, for example, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I think the Dutch really like their train silent. It's not like there have been great videos anyway, because the rain on the window makes it very hard to film outside. And besides, I believe most of the routes for trains were chosen based on which ones were easiest or fastest, not on the scenic views. So there's not that much to see. But I hailed a cab from the central station, and the first place I'm here is the Corpus Experience. So if you can see, this is, in fact, it looks so much like a body that my gimbal thinks it's the one it should focus on. But actually, I am the person. So you can see, it's like a really tall statue, and inside it, there are like rooms that represent the human body. So, okay, we're back. Here, find me. Okay, sure. And this is mostly geared towards children's school tours and families, but as a medical doctor, I couldn't not visit a place that literally tries to be a huge anatomy display. So I'll try to give a more technical view on this family attraction. So I went before and bought my ticket because I didn't know if they would have me. As I said before, since I am filming this for YouTube, if places don't allow me to film in, then there's very little incentive for me to actually go there and record, so I'll probably go away if they said no. But they said yes, so I've already bought my ticket. It cost me around 25 euros, 24.95. And luckily I can leave in about 10 minutes on the next tour. So it should be a relatively quick stay here, and we can start very soon. The rain remains light, no significant problems here. So I'll make a cut and continue it later once we're ready to start. Future Ricardo speaking here. So this is what we actually went through. We came inside here on the knees through this staircase. Then we came around through the splinter that got through the muscle fibers. Then we got into the womb and extended to an elevator to the next floor. Then we came here to the right. On one of the chambers we saw the kidneys. Then the bowels. And then we came to another elevator where we were at the lungs, under and up. So through lungs, then we came to the next chamber. I'm not really sure what this one was, just from seeing it here. And then to another elevator with some images there. This one I think was the heart one, the one that moves. Then we ascended again, then onto the mouth. And then we used it and... No, that's not right. Or perhaps we use the escalator to come up. Then another... Oh, okay. So it's not, I think, completely accurate, perhaps. Then I came here to the ear. And then from the nose, another chamber. Mm-hmm. We ascended to an elevator to the eye. To the very last place. And here we are. We ended at the brain. Okay, so overall it was an interesting experience. It has just ended. I intended to record more inside there. My original idea was to show some structures and point them out and talk about some diseases or something like that. Okay, so it's mostly high school level. It's interesting. But that was mostly not possible, partially because it's a very, I'm not sure how to say it, a tight shadow. You are expected to spend like 5 minutes in one room and then move on to the next. So yeah, I think this is like a miniature of what you've seen. It's kind of hard to say like, okay, I'm going to stay here longer and just talk about it. I'm not sure whether they would not allow it, but it would be not very practical. Anyway, so it was really interesting. I would say it's, I'm not sure whether I expected more interactivity. It's, there are many beautiful pieces, and overall I'd say like it's a bit like a budget simulator. And I don't say that negatively. It's extremely hard to have like a simulator. You don't get to build one for $10,000. This is evidently a very complex structure, and even doing something relatively simple tends to be very expensive and require a lot of knowledge. So, would I recommend coming here? Well, if you are like traveling to Amsterdam to get a train to come here to Leiden only for this, then no, absolutely not. I would not say it's necessarily worth the travel for someone who is here on tourism. Now, if you live in Leiden, for example, or something like that, then perhaps it could make a lot more sense. I'm sure children would love it. I would have thought it very interesting when I was a child, and it would be a great experience for children and for families. Most of it is like, I'd say, secondary level. I am pretty sure that, like, as a medical doctor or as a medical student, there is absolutely nothing you won't already know. Perhaps some trivia, like, how many times your heart beats how many times your heart beats throughout your entire life. They said stupid and I have no idea whether this information is correct. It's not something that I have to provide to a patient, for example. But overall, I'd say perhaps a child might not understand it all. But I'm trying to get some of the views from light in here. But oh, I know I'm going to get the tripod up. And so now, okay, somewhat should be easier to see. And it should be interesting, for example, for perhaps a high school student, even more if it's an elementary student. I would say the level of knowledge in most things is slightly below what you would be expected to know once you finish secondary education, for example, and definitely below what you learn in university. But there are some more interesting pieces. There are throughout three elevators, which are the areas that have more interactivity. Most of the rooms are like large models. It reminds me a lot of many things I saw at children's, not children's parks, but children's museums geared toward children. That kind of room that's painted and sculpted according to different structures. And there are many screens and they explain exactly what's happening here and there. And it, perhaps these specific parts
it'd be a bit more interactive. But it's not as far as interesting, and as I said, one to expect an amusement out of a museum. But the elevators have their peculiarities. Like, something that surprised me quite a lot was that in the area geared towards the nose, there is actually snow. So that was pretty surprising. And the hard area, I think, was the most fun. There is some of those moving chairs, and that's kind of what I mean by a budget simulator. They say that I don't mean that in a negative way, but it very slightly reminds someone of something you would see, for example, at Disney World or someplace like that. A beach up gimbal, I'm not that low. Okay, but so now a bit low, why did you go so low? So it was an interesting experience if I would stay some time in my study here or living here. I would definitely pay a visit. Would be great for children. I think I wouldn't come here all the way from Amsterdam or Rotterdam if I was on tourism, for example. Overall, for the 25 euros, I think it was worth the experience. It was undoubtedly an interesting place to see. And to some minor peculiarities I could mention, for example, if I want to nitpick that the headphones you receive, most of what I heard you won't be able to hear because they're wearing headphones. The headphones are a bit hard to get right because they go behind your neck, and especially for wearing a heavy coat, it conflicts a bit with your clothes, so they're always falling off. But I mean, it's not something that really is a problem to the overall experience overall. So, yeah. I'm glad I came here, which was an interesting experience. And to some degree, the view of light in itself from here is already something worth seeing. Thank you. So now I'm going probably to the Borja Rips Museum. And if you want to follow up, it's probably going to be the next video. Thank you.
Thank you.
And so here we are, literally at the very end, at the gift shop. Always ends in a gift shop. And it's actually quite interesting. They sell a lot of anatomy memorabilia, so to speak. Like these decorations, for example, containing anatomical drawings. But what I actually think is more interesting are the anatomical plushes. I've got to ask them if they manufacture these themselves or if they have a supplier. I'd love to work with them on this. Don't they want a distributor?